Welcome back children, I hope you are doing well. In previous video, we have learned MS Word 2010 interface. I hope you all understood the lesson. Now, in this video, we will study about formatting text in MS Word 2010. Dear children, in this lesson, you will learn about changing fonts, font sizes, font styles, and font colors. Highlighting text, applying borders and shadings, text alignment, center, left, right, and justify, bullets and numbering. Formatting is organizing or arranging the text according to a chosen pattern. It helps in changing the appearance of the text. This is done by using different fonts, colors, sizes, and styles. Every software package has predefined settings. These are called default settings. Formatting helps you to change the default settings of the computer according to your choice. In this lesson, you will learn about different ways to format text. When you are formatting text, you need not highlight the entire text. Placing the cursor anywhere in the text enables you to format that part. Similarly, you can format and enter entire paragraph. Once the settings of the text in the paragraph are selected, subsequent paragraphs will have the same format unless the format is changed. Formatting text. Formatting is the process of applying font styles, characteristics, colors, etc. to a text or a paragraph. In other words, it is the way the text appears on a page. The default font in MS Word 2010 is Calibri. The default font size is 11 point. Thus, any new Word document in MS Word 2010 would have the text in Calibri 11 points by default. In MS Word 2010, the formatting of the text document can be done by, number 1, selecting different options given in the font group of the Home tab. Number 2, we can also select different options through the font dialog box launcher in the font group of the Home tab. Font name. A font is a set of letters and symbols in a particular design and size. Each font has a name. Some of the examples of fonts are listed here. Children, if you have computer or laptop at your home, you can try this. Select a part of the text. Click on the font name drop-down list and bring the mouse pointer on a font name to preview the selected text in that font. Do the same with other fonts and at the end, click on the desired font name. Font size. The size of the text is called the font size. It is measured in points. There are 72 points. A few examples are given here. Students, you can try this also at your home. Select a portion of the text. Select the increase font size option in the font group of the home tab and increase the font size by a point. The reverse can be done using the decrease font size option. Font style. The way in which a character is emphasized is called its font style. The most common styles are bold, italic, and underline. Bold. Bold text is printed darker than normal text so that words and paras stand out on a page. It is often used for title and headings. Italic. Italic text is slanted. It is mostly used for emphasis. It is sometimes used for heading and also for representing scientific names. Underline. Underlined text has a line under it. In the font dialog box, you can select the underline style from the drop-down list. From the underline color drop-down list, you can select the line color. It is also used to emphasize the text. It is sometimes used for the title of a publication. You can also choose the more underlines option from the underline drop-down list. A font dialog box opens from where more styles for underlining the text can be chosen. Normal text is the default style for a document. Superscript and subscript. Superscript. Superscript reduces the size of the text and raises it to the top of the current line. For example, today is 5th January. Here, TH after the digit 5 is a superscript. Subscript. Subscript is a text style that reduces the size of the text and lowers it to the bottom of the current line. For example, the chemical formula of water is H2O. Here, the base 2 is a subscript. Font color. It is used to change the color of the text to emphasize headings, subheadings, and other text. Using bright and too many colors in a single document are usually not recommended. Highlighting text. You can highlight the text in a Word document with different colors. It is usually done to mark some important facts in the text. The steps to highlight the text are: number 1. Click on the text highlight color drop-down list in the font group of the Home tab. You may also choose different colors for highlighting. Number 2. The cursor changes to a highlighter pen. Move the pen over the text that has to be highlighted. Number 3. To remove the highlight from the text, select the no color option from the text highlight color drop-down list. Applying borders and shading. Follow these steps to apply borders and shading effects to the text. Number 1. Select the text where the borders and shading effect is to be applied. Number 2. Click on the bottom border drop-down list in the paragraph group of the home tab. Number 3, select the borders and shading option in the drop-down list. The borders and shading dialog box appears. Number 4, click on the borders tab and choose the desired box style from the setting section. Click on none to remove the borders. Number 5, you can also select the style, color and width of the lines, making the border from the style, color and width sections representatively. The preview section shows how the border will look when applied the text. Number 6, go to apply to drop down list and select paragraph. Number 7, click on the shading tab, select the color for shading from the fill drop down list. Number 8, you can also select the shading style and color using the style and color options representatively in the patterns section. The preview corner shows how the shading effect will look when applied to the text. Number 9, click on the OK button to apply the border and shading effects to the selected text. With this, we end with this chapter. Let's meet in the next video. Till then, thank you. Stay safe. Bye-bye.